The core question of this whole project is why remove the Scotts Mills Dam? The answer is simple. When you look at all of the options, dam removal is the clear best choice. That's primarily because of all the benefits that dam removal brings to the Scotts Mills community. But additionally, it's because there are no good alternatives to removal.
Besides removal, there are two options. Repair the dam, or do nothing and let the dam continue to fail. We made a whole video on the barriers to repairing the dam, but the short answer is that the cost of repairs, difficulty of obtaining permits, and the lack of an incentivized dam owner make completing repairs almost impossible. As for doing nothing, that would create a pile of negative consequences. As the dam crumbles, the park's main swimming hole would be filled with concrete and boulders. Visitors would be in greater danger from unstable sections of the dam, and the kiddie pool would be lost anyway. On the other hand, removing the Scotts Mills Dam has many benefits. It preserves the swimming hole below the falls, the park's most important swimming area. It stops park visitors from using the dam as a sidewalk, and would likely lessen the amount of visitors crossing the creek to jump off the falls. It ends the dam issue forever, with no lingering maintenance requirements, repairs, or liability issues. It fully opens up 19 miles of high-quality Chinook and steelhead habitat, and it restores Scotts Mills Falls as a scenic landmark that could draw year-round visitors to the park and community. It also has the least amount of drawbacks. The loss of the kiddie pool, which is only usable in May and June and is crumbling anyway. The closure of the park for a couple weeks, one September. And the loss of the dam as a piece of history. While this is important, the dam is being lost anyway. And as part of removal, we're committed to commemorating the dam so that park visitors can learn about its history even when it's gone. Before we wrap up, let's look at a few common myths about Scotts Mills Dam removal. Number one, the dam was built in 1847 and played an important role in founding the town of Scotts Mills. The dam was actually built in 1917, 70 years after the earliest settlers arrived to the Scotts Mills area. It was primarily used as a hydropower plant, which PGE closed in 1954. The dam has now been abandoned for almost twice as long as it was ever in use. Number two, the Scotts Mills community is united against dam removal. The truth is that locals are divided about the project. On the supporters' side, city leaders like the mayor and city council support dam removal, with the city council voting in 2019 and in 2023 to support the project. On the opponent side, there is a dedicated group of community members trying to stop removal from happening.
Thanks for watching. If you have questions or feedback or want to get involved, check out the link in the description. Additionally, you can learn more about dam removal by watching our other two videos or looking at the interactive PDF that is also linked in the description.